morning and a very warm welcome to beginning the day with God in this season of Easter. Today we continue to follow the stations of the resurrection. Today, the women at the tomb. Our opening piece of music was the hymn, See, What a Morning. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we will certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. But if we have died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. So you also must consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Christ Jesus. Risen Lord, as we set out on this pilgrimage of faith, we pray that you will guide our steps so that we may find you in both darkness and light. Here we stand among Mary Magdalene, Peter, John, and all the disciples as witnesses of your triumph over sin and death.
Direct our meditations that the seeds of your resurrection, Eastering in our hearts, may take root, blossom, and be fruitful in our lives.
Amen. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life.
Lord, you are our way, our truth, and our life. Alleluia.
Today's reading comes from St. Luke's Gospel, chapter 24. Suddenly, two men in dazzling clothes stood beside them. The women were terrified, and they bowed their faces to the ground. But the men said to them, Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here, but has risen. Thanks be to God.
And now to our reflection. The entrance is unguarded, the stone cast aside. The grave clothes are abandoned and the tomb is empty. Empty apart from the women's own whispered and echoing voices. Frightened voices. Where is the body? What have they done to him? Excited voices. What does this mean? Do you remember what he said would happen to him? And sceptical voices. What sort of a trick is this? Then suddenly two figures in dazzling clothes are standing beside them. Is this a trap? Have they blocked the entrance? Are the women now the ones entombed? Are they to be counted as dead? They wrestle with their senses, which are assaulted from all directions. Take sight. They have seen the stone rolled away, the body absent, the iridescent angel clothes. Take smell. There is no stench of death. The tomb is fresh and airy. Take touch. They had felt the weight and the solidity of the stone and had handled the grave clothes, which were folded neatly, as if by someone with no need to hurry, with time to spare. Take taste, a tang of fear in their mouths. Now they hear, Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here, but has risen. The breath has been knocked clean out of them. After the vicious spectacle of his crucifixion, everything that mattered had been destroyed. The women had felt utterly stricken, all hope and purpose torn from them. But now, where was this tumult of emotions leading them? Was there hope after all? Could they trust the evidence of their senses? Could they truly believe what their Lord had said about his death and rising again? Amen.
Let us now together pray the words that Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Risen Lord Jesus, when you broke free of the tomb, you overturned rules and systems that chain us to false expectations. Just as your friends and followers needed the presence of angels to prompt them to grasp the possibilities of your resurrection, we ask you to equip us to be your messengers, overcoming fear and allowing others to see your infinite love working throughout the twists and turns of life.
Amen.
We praise you, O Lord, and we bless you.
By your dying, death was destroyed. By your rising, life was renewed. By your Spirit, may we be filled with your glory.
Amen. Amen.